हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन फिफ्थ चैप्टर लाइंस एंड एंगल्स टुडे वी सॉल्व द लॉन्ग क्वेश्चंस। इन दैट फर्स्ट वन लुक इन द गिवन फिगर एक्स वाई पैरेलल टू ए बी। हियर एक्स वाई इन पैरेलल टू लाइंस आर देयर एंड बोथ आर पैरेलल। द आंसर इज सी डी। दिस वन इज इंटरसेक्ट एक्स वाई एट पी एंड ए बी एट क्यू रिस्पेक्टिवली। If CPX, this angle is given, which is 50 degree, find the measure of other angles. Okay, CPD is given, then find out rest of other all angles. Okay, let we solve that one. Here, the figure. Look, XY and AB are parallel. CD is transversal. P and Q are intersecting point, and here 50 degree angle is there. So first write down that angle. Angle CPX equal to 50 degree, which is given. Just write down given. Okay. Now we are having some pair of angles are there. They are the corresponding angles, alternate angles, and inter angles to the same side of transversal. Okay. So here XT angle is there. So we are having two pair. One is corresponding angle, otherwise exterior side. So alternate exterior angles. Okay. We use here the corresponding angle. Now, which one is corresponding of CPX? CP is exterior. So you just take interior angle at downside. Okay. That is PQA. This one is. Okay. That is also okay. So angle PQA is equal to angle CPX. That is equal to CPX. Why it's equal? Because they are the pair of corresponding angle. Because they are pair of corresponding angle. So that is also 50 degree. So PQA equal to 50. Write down here the measurement 50 degree. Okay. So that is 50 degree. Now PQA is interior side. Okay. So we do the pair, means we make the pair with interior angle of PQA. That is YPQ. Look this one. Okay. Both are interior and opposite side means they are called pair of alternate interior angles. Okay. And they are equal in measurement. So angle YPQ is equal to angle PQA. These two are equal because they are pair of alternate interior. Angle. Okay. They are pair of alternate interior angle. So this one is also 50 degree. Okay. Now YPQ and BQD. This one. Look, both are same side of transversal. One is interior, one is exterior. So they are pair of corresponding angles. Okay. So BQD and YPQ are equal. So angle BQD equal to angle they are YPQ. Okay. Because they are pair of corresponding angle. Okay. Here one mistake is there. Look, PQA and PQR. You just write down the measurement of PQA. That is 50 degree. Means YPQ is also 50. Okay. Now BPQ equal to means BPQ. Now put the value of YPQ. So angle BQD is also equal to 50 degree because measurement of this one is 50 degree. Okay. Otherwise, you just write down the numbers here. 1, 2, 3. Okay. and one angle is already given, so means you just find out another 7 angles. This one is also 50. Complete? Okay. Now another angles. Look, XPQ and PQA, they are interior angles to the same side of the transverse. Otherwise, you just take YPQ and PQB. Okay, we take this one. So angle XPQ, okay, and angle PQA, XPQ means this one, and PQA are pair of interior angle. Okay. On the same side of transversal. So that means XPQ plus PQA equal to 180, because we know that in a pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal, both angles are supplementary. Okay. Now PQA is 50 degree. So angle XPQ plus 50 equal to 180. Means angle XPQ equal to 180 minus 50. Side chain, that is equal to 130 degree. Okay. Means XPQ, this angle equal to 130. Okay, now look, XPQ and AQD, these two angles are corresponding. Okay, so here angle AQD, this one, angle AQD equal to angle XPQ, because they are pair of corresponding angles. Okay, so angle AQD equal to XPQ is 130. Okay, so that is 130. This one is also 130. Look here, the fourth number, and this one is fifth number. Means write down here, that is 130. Okay, now XPQ and PQB, this one, these two are alternate interior angles. Okay, so write down that one, angle PQB equal to angle XPQ, because they are pair of alternate interior angle. Okay, so angle PQB equal to also 130, number 6. Means this one is also 130. And look, CPY and PQB, corresponding angles. Okay, otherwise you just write down this one, XPQ and CPY, they are vertically opposite angles. Okay, it's same. Here we write down the corresponding angles. So angle CPY, this one, CPY, this one, this angle. Okay, that is equal to angle PQB, because they are corresponding angles. You just write down pair of corresponding angles. Okay, so angle CPY equal to also 130, that is 7 number. Okay, so here our 7 angles completed, and one is given, so means measurement of all angles are that this one is 130. all angles are there. Okay, so you also prove that yourself. Okay, if you have any problem, then see this video and try to solve that one. Okay, one more question is there. In that, you just write down in adjacent figures, the figure is there. Just write down pair of corresponding angles, alternate interior angles, and pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal only. Okay, in short, I show you that very firstly. You just write down yourself. Okay, pair of corresponding means same side of transversal, and one is exterior, one is interior. So they are, look, angle 1 and 5, first pair, second 2 and 6, third one 4 and 8, next one is 3 and 7. Okay, so total 4 pairs are there which are corresponding angles. Pair of alternate interior angle, alternate angles, they are opposite side of transversal. Okay, and interior means both are interior, so they are 4 and 6, first pair, and second one is angle 3 and angle 5. Okay, in the pair of interior angles on the same side, they are, first pair is angle 4 and 5, second one is 3 and 6. Okay, so write down yourself. Clear? So here our chapter number 5, revision of chapter number 5 is completed. In next video, we revise next chapter. Okay, thank you.